Equestrian.tv in NYC. Today we're going to do a tutorial on the horned harris. So basically we're going to start with a little BB cream underneath the eyes and a little above the eyes as well. But we want to make sure we get all the redness out. And then we're going to take, I like to use this brush here. This brush is magical. It just helps me blend in my BB cream. And it allows me to do pretty deep. And don't forget to go under the eye. And just be gentle. Studio Sculpt by MAC, and it has SPF in it, so it's really good. Use the color that you prefer. I'm going a little light on this makeup tutorial, so with a stippling brush, you definitely want to just put a little bit of the Studio Sculpt on there. Basically, I like to work with the top of my hand, so just dab it on the top of your hand as well. Not going to go too crazy, but just enough just to get nice even coverage. Around the skin. I kind of want it on the lighter side. And just a little bit more. A nice base for what we're going to be doing. I pulled my hair back just to make it easier to apply makeup. Again, you don't need a ton of makeup. Just a nice coating. To have a nice balanced skin. Okay, next what we're going to do is I'm going to use Aveda's Cotton Dual Base Powder. And basically I'm going to take a very, very wide powder brush, like so, and work it around. Work it around my hair. Basically it will just set the foundation. Take a little of the NYX pencil and use that so the color has something to adhere to. That's why I like to use this, because it really does set the color. And again, I go back with this and work it. To kind of lighten and brighten. The same thing in this area, you just want to lighten and brighten. I'm going to use Urban Decay's primer for the eyeshadow. Okay? And basically, with the primer, I'm going to use my bladder brush. And again, use the back of my hand. Not that much primer. Not very much at all. But enough to cover the eyelids so that putting on it will stay put. So I'm going to take a white thin pencil and we're going to draw out the design. The reason why I use white is that if you make a mistake, it's easy to clean up. So I'm going to use black next. I'm going to follow the same here. I'm going to bring it up over slightly over the eyebrow, but right in the corner of the nose and the eye, just in that little curved area. See how easy that is? Rub it off just in here, and then this part will be right about there. Okay. One right here. So you can see it. Just a little bit of gel eyeliner. Thank you.
time for the hair. Make sure you have prepared 4 clip-ons and start braiding them. You'll be needing a small package of Goody rubber bands to tie off the braids. Make 2 ponytails and braid each one. Seal the edges off with a Goody rubber band. Twist them around each ponytail and insert a couple of bobby pins just to keep it in place. And then we'll be adding on our extensions and doing the same. Woohoo! We're done! Yay!